Hello student, good morning. Today we are going to study about the design of cascade aerator. It is a new topic related to how to design any water treatment component regarding its design criteria. Okay, first of all I would like to brush up your concept regarding the cascade aerator, that how it looks like and what are the components which we have to design based on the design criteria which is issued by the Indian standards. Okay. So first of all you have to go through this. This is the circular type cascade aerator. This is we have to design, that is it consists of various types of cascades, that is steps. Generally 4 to 6 cascades are provided in the cascade aerator, in which the at the from the center and at the bottom an inlet pipe is provided. Through the in the inlet pipe an inlet water is allowed to, that raw water is allowed through this inlet pipe, so that the water can exposed into the atmosphere, and the exposed water and that aerated water can be collected into the cascade, and further the water will fall over the cascade from one cascade to another and another to further cascades, and later it is collected at the collecting chamber which is shown at the bottom of the cascade aerator. So we have to design about these about the this structure of cascade aerator, in which there are the components, like this is the inlet aerator, this is the bottom area or the cascades, and this is about the top of the cascade aerator, that is about the tip of the aerator. So this is the actual photograph of cascade work cascade aerator, of working of cascade aerator, in which you can see the flowing water is flown from the tip, and at the tip the water will fall under the action of the gravity, and it is fall from one cascade to another, and later it is collected at the collecting chamber, and further it is passed to the next component for further treatment of the water. So these are the 6 types of design criteria. Based on these criteria we have to design the cascade aerator, and it is a very very important question regarding to RTMNU examination point of view. So point number 1, that is the velocity of flow of water through the aerator is, that is 0.3 meter per second to 1.2 meter per second. Okay, means the velocity should be minimum is 0.3 meter per second to maximum 1.2 meter per second, so that we can keep the velocity of water up to in this range only. Okay, similarly second point is total area of aerator required is, means how much area is required for the aerator is 0.01 meter square per meter cube per hour. So what is meter cube per hour? That is it is the discharge, that is 1 meter cube per hour discharge, it is required 0.015 meter square to 0.045 meter square per meter cube per hour. So this is the total area required for the aerator is, that is minimum is 0.015 meter square per meter cube per hour to 0.045 meter square per meter cube per hour. Similarly point number 3 is regarding the height of the aerator, that the minimum height of the aerator should be 3 meter and the maximum height of the aerator should be 6 meter, so that we have to set the height of the aerator according to these dimensions only. Also what is the fourth design criteria, that is number of steps provided in the cascade aerator should be 4 numbers to maximum 6 numbers. Okay, so these are the steps, that is cascades which we have to provide in the cascade aerator regarding for the design of cascade aerator is 4 numbers, that is minimum to maximum 6 numbers. So what should be the next point is, what should be the diameter of tip? Means we have to determine the diameter of tip based on the formula, that is the diameter of bottom cascade divided by number of steps provided, and it should be greater than the diameter of inlet. So using this formula, we have to calculate the diameter of tip, and after calculating the diameter of tip, we have to calculate that is the first diameter of cascade, that is the first periphery of the cascade is, that is 2 times of diameter of the tip. So based on these design criteria, we have to calculate, or we have to design the cascade aerator. So how the question will be asked, will going to be asked in your examination point of in your examination. So question: that design a cascade aerator for the discharge of 25 mld and assume suitable data wherever required. So this is the only question is going to be asked for your examination. And what is the discharge means? 25 mld means total quantity of water to be flown in the aerator is given as 25 mld. Now what is mld stands for? That is million liter per day. You should have to be careful regarding this mld, that is 25 million liter per day. So what is the given data? Now how do we have to calculate, how we have to design? So first of all, we have to write the given data, that is discharge, always denoted by the capital Q, that is 25 mld. That is, we have to write the first as it is the value which is given in the question. Now what is m? M stands for million liter, and what is l and d? That is liters per day. Now what is million? Millions means 10 lakhs. So I have written here, that is 25 into 10 to the power 6 liters per day. So I have substituted that m value by 10 to the power 6 liters per day. So now we have to ultimately get the dimensions regarding the cascade aerator. So therefore we have to convert the value by liter into the meters. So how can we convert the liters into the meter? You have to keep it in your mind that in 1 meter cube, that is in 1 meter cube tank. Now what is 1 meter cube tank? A tank having dimension 1 meter by 1 meter by 1 meter, that is 1 meter of length, 1 meter of breadth, and 1 meter of height, that is 1 meter cube, carries 1000 liters of water. So therefore we have substituted 1 liter, that is about 1000 meter cube of water. Therefore 25 10 to the power 6 as it is into 10 to the power minus 3, that is meter cube, divided by day, and we have to convert that day into the seconds. Therefore one day means 24 hours, and in 24 hours it carries 60 minutes, therefore it is 60, and in 60 minutes in 1 minute it carries 60 seconds, therefore into 60. Therefore when we have to convert the day into the 60 into the seconds, we have to convert into in this fashion, that is 24 into 60 into 60. Therefore the value comes out by the calculation as 0.289 meter cube per second. So this is the conversion factor which you have to get involved in the various, primarily in various numericals. That is, always the discharge will be given in your million liter per day, and you have to convert that value, million liter per day, in the meter cube per seconds or meter cube per hour. So as the value required in meter cube per hour, because the criteria are given in meter cube per hour, therefore we have written both the values as in meter cube per second and meter cube per hour. So by replacing 60 into 60, हम अगर 60 into 60 को अगर नहीं लिखेंगे, by simply divide by 24 करेंगे, तो हमको 1041.6 की वैल्यू मिल जाएगी. देयरफॉर इट इज नोन एज मीटर क्यूब पर आवर. ठीक है ना. नाउ फर्स्ट स्टेप, बाय आफ्टर सिंप्लीफाइंग द डिस्चार्ज इन मीटर क्यूब पर आवर एंड मीटर क्यूब पर सेकेंड, दैट इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप, दैट इज डिजाइन ऑफ इनलेट पाइप. नाउ how we have to design by inlet pipe, we have to first use the continuity equation. This is a very much important question, important equation, that is continuity equation, that is Q is equal to A into V, where Q is discharge, A is area, and V is velocity. Now, but here is two unknowns are given, because we don't know the velocity, we don't know the area. So therefore, how we can calculate this equation? But we have the design criteria with us, that is, which says that the velocity of flow of water through the aerator should be 0.3 meter per second to 1.2 meter per second. Means it is the value which is given to us, means we can use any value between in this range. So we have assumed, means we can assume any value between this range. So I have assumed the value as 1 meter per second. So this is the value is, so we have rounded off. Q value is here 0.289, say it is 0.29 meter cube per second, that is discharge, and we are assuming that the velocity of flow through the inlet pipe is 1 meter per second. Therefore, substituting that one into the equation, and we can find the area of the inlet pipe. Now, how the area of the inlet pipe comes as, you can see here, I have substituted the value of Q is 0.29, velocity, that is V, as 1, that is what left, that is area. Now we know that the pipe is circular in shape, therefore we have substituted the area as the area of pipe, that is pi by 4 into d square. We have substituted small d because we are going to get equipped with two type of diameter, that is diameter of cascade aerator and diameter of pipe. So we are using small d for diameter of pipe, and we will use capital D for the diameter of cascade aerator. So for by substituting as V is equal to 1, and by simplifying this equation, I am getting the value as D is equal to 0.60 meter per second. Therefore, by actual area of the inlet, means that is the diameter of D is this 0.6 meter, by substituting that D into this equation, that is the area of the inlet pipe, I am getting the actual inlet area of inlet pipe is A is equal to 0.28 meter square. So this is about the design of inlet pipe. Means we have to get design the about the diameter of the inlet pipe. Now, second is, again I'm going to show this sketch, that is, we have simplified only this pipe, that is the inlet pipe, by substituting the velocity of the water through this pipe as 1 meter per second, and we are getting the diameter of inlet pipe as 0.6 meter, and therefore total area of the inlet pipe is how much is 0.6 meter. Okay, now again I am moving to the numerical point, and that is the second part of the numerical, that is the design of bottom cascade. Now, what is the design of bottom cascade? This is the bottom cascade, means the overall design of the bottom cascade. Now, here the discharge is 1041.6 meter cube per hour. Now, from where we have get this value, we have calculated the discharge in two form, that is in meter cube per hour and in meter cube per second. So in first instance we have picked the value in meter cube per second, and in second instance we have used condition we are going to use the value is, that is, meter cube per hour, because the given criteria is given to us in meter cube per hour. Okay, so assume the total area required for aerator is 0.030 meter square per meter cube per hour. Now, from where this value comes out, the question is arises again. I am showing to you that the design criteria, that how, what design criteria says this, that the total area for aerator required is, means 0.015 meter square per meter cube per hour to 0.045 meter square per meter cube per hour. So I am using the center value of this, that is 0.030 meter square per meter cube per hour. So therefore I have assumed this as the total area required for the aerator is 0.030 meter square per meter cube per hour. So now the total area of aerator is, now how the value comes to us, this is the discharge into the this value. Now the meter cube per hour and meter cube per hour will get cancelled because it is per, it is, that is divided by meter cube per hour. So we have multiplied to each other, therefore the total area of aerator comes out to be, that is 31.25 meter square, that is the area of aerator. Also the actual area of inlet pipe is also given to us, that is the 0.28 meter square, because, and we have to add this 0.28 into the aerator because this 0.28, that is the inlet pipe, is passing through the cascade aerator, therefore the area will, the gross area will increase, therefore we have to add the inlet pipe area along with the area of the cascade aerator. Therefore the gross area of aerator comes out to be, that is 31.25, that is the area of aerator, plus 0.28, that is the actual area of inlet, that is, it is comes out to be 31.53 meter square. Therefore now the total gross diameter of the aerator is, now that is the bottom diameter of the aerator is, now what is bottom diameter, that is, this is the bottom diameter, this is the bottom diameter after adding the inlet pipe. Now the we got the total area of the bottom area of the aerator. Now then it is a circular type, then we can calculate the bottom diameter. So by using pi by 4 into d square is equal to 31.53, therefore the diameter comes out to be 31.33, therefore say it, that is by round it off, d is equal to 6.35 meter. So up till now we have completed about the two part, that is first part is diameter of inlet pipe and second part is diameter of bottom cascade aerator. Now the third part, that is the dimension of aerator. Now what is dimensions of aerator, means in the third part we have to calculate from the adjacent above area of the cascade aerator, that is we have to design the cascades, that is steps, and we have to design the height, etc. So these are known as the type C, that is step C dimension of aerator. Assume the height of aerator is 3 meter and the riser to be provided is 5 numbers. Now how we can assume, again the design criteria gives us the permission or the freedom, that is the height of aerator should be 3 meter to 6 meter, therefore we are assuming it as 5 meter, and number of steps to be provided between 4 numbers to 6 numbers, therefore we are choosing it as 5 numbers. So therefore we are assuming it as the height of aerator is 3 meter and the riser to be provided, that is the number of steps to be provided, is 5 numbers, therefore the height of each riser comes to be, that is if the total height from the bottom is 3 meter and the number of steps to be provided is 5 numbers, therefore the height of each riser, that is this riser, is 3 by 5, means total height divided by number of risers is equal to 0.6 meter, that is 0.6 meter is the value of each riser. This is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 riser, means these are the 5 risers. So depending on the height of each riser, we have to calculate the diameter of the tip, that is at the top where from the water will fall to the number of cascades. So it is given by a formula, that is the diameter of bottom cascade divided by number of riser provided. That is the, what is the diameter of bottom cascade? This is 6.35, number of risers provided divided by 5, that which is comes out to be 1.27 meter, and it should be greater than diameter of inlet pipe, therefore it is okay. And hence, the diameter of first cascade, that is at the top, that is at the, is twice of diameter of tip, is equal to 2 into 1.27, that is 2.54. diameter of second cascade is 3 into diameter of tip, is equal to 3 into 1.7, that is equal to 3.84. similarly, we will find all the diameters of, this is first cascade, second cascade, third cascade and fourth cascade, by multiplying 2, 3, 4 and 5 respectively with the diameter of tip, and we will get the value as 2.54 meter, 3.8581 meter, 5.0108 meter and 6.38 meter. Mistakenly it is here written as centimeter, but it is meter. So in this fashion, this is the, and hence at the bottom cascade, that is the fourth, it is it should be checked at it should be comes out to be the diameter of bottom cascade. Means we have concluded our design, that is we have concluded our design, and at the bottom and at the side we have assumed that the width of collecting channel is 1 meter. Means the water which is flown from the various cascades, it should be collect at the collecting channel. So therefore we have assumed that it is the width of the collecting channel is 1 meter, and this is the, and height, and there is a free board of 0.3 meter. It is from where there should be a free board. So therefore the total height is 1 meter. So what is the summary? Means in this way we have completed our design, and this is the design summary. Means we are, what are the findings of our design? That is the diameter of inlet pipe, that is 0.6, diameter of bottom cascade 6.35 meter, diameter, number of risers, means we have provided now 5 numbers, height of each risers 0.6 meter, diameter of dip tip, that is 1.27 meter, width of collecting channel, that is 1 meter, and height of collecting channel is 1 meter. And here similarly, so this is the your final design. As per your design, your dimensions, which we have calculated, is shown in this sketch. That is the design of cascade elevator, that is at the top this is the tip, and from here, that is first, it is the inlet pipe, means the pipe is run in this way, and it is the diameter of pipe is 0.6 meter at the top, it is the tip, that is 1.27 meter, which is shown in this way. First cascade, that is 2 times of tip, that is 2.54. Second cascade, 3 times of tip, that is 3.81 meter. Fourth cascade, that is 3 times of tip, 4 times of tip, that is 5.08 meter. And last cascade, that is 6. That is, we have find it out the bottom cascade, that is 6.35 meter. And here, this is, these are the collecting channels which run at the periphery of the cascade aerator to collect the water which is fall from this aerator, and which carries the water from the next to the next component. So these are the collecting channel, and these are the risers. And here in this way the cascade aerator design completes. So if you have any doubt, please write it in the comment section. And I hope I hope this will understood for your examination point of view, and this is a very very important question. And if you have any doubt related to this, you can ask in the comment section. Okay, I'm completing this, and I'm signing off. Thank you.